Step aside, Merkava 4, there's a new boy in town. After waiting for so long, it is finally here. A tank powered with amazing artificial intelligence capabilities and several advanced tech features that wouldn't just make the previous generation of tanks look like child's play but also change the art of tactical warfare forever. Strap in as we unpack every cool feature down to the last detail. Try not to drop your jaws too much. It may sound like a hype ad, but we're not even kidding. The Barak is so good that we have no doubt it will bring in a new era. The technological leaps on this machine are the stuff of legends. From an unprecedented use of artificial intelligence to top-tier sensors, radars, and cameras, it's undeniably Israel's most formidable combat vehicle to date. Don't take it the wrong way though, the Merkava 4 did a lot of things right. But you know what they say, everything worthwhile under the sun must have some flaws. In this case, the placement of its engine and exhaust. You see, a front-mounted engine, as on the Merkava, is more prone to damage than conventional configurations. It risks tank immobilization or, worse, an explosion. Almost every attack that hits the front of the tank results in fatal damage, and do you want to know what makes it worse? The front side exhaust is another annoying weak point susceptible to easy penetration. To make the next generation of tanks, Israel knew they had to go back to the drawing board. They knew a lot of things had to be worked on. But boy did they do their homework. The Barak, which translates to lightning in English, sports a full 360 degrees awareness environment that gives soldiers an unprecedented view of their surroundings. Known as Iron Vision, this new system was created by Elbit Systems to change the status quo of command roles. Imagine you're a soldier in this amazing tank offering 360 degrees vision. Wouldn't you say your situational awareness will be heightened? But it doesn't end there. Thanks to artificial intelligence, the crew will be able to see through the vehicle's armor. Elbit also disclosed the Iron Vision system will also be getting image processing skills that will help its sensors sort through data and identify things instantly to differentiate between foes and harmless objects in the background. This will be particularly helpful for operators as they'll be able to fight while the tank is completely sealed, with no hatches open, unlike previous Merkava models where soldiers would either be vulnerable to sniper fire or be blinded by debris. Another new feature that caught our attention is the new operating system that follows the tenets of machine learning. It was specially designed in a way that allows the system to keep analyzing past events in warfare to get better as time goes on. It can adapt itself to user needs and provide suitable options for its operator to pick the best settings for any task. Nevertheless, the Defense Ministry claims the operating system will be easy to use and that soldiers will not need to constantly learn how to use new functions. However, given that there's no practical action to buttress this yet, we don't know for sure. But, what we do know, however, is that the Barak will come with an improved system that will enhance its firing abilities. Known as the Windbreaker, this impressive control system was used on the Merkava MK4 and ensured it made accurate attacks, whether the tank was stationary or in motion, even under the cover of night. But guys, the Barak will be able to intercept incoming missiles. And let's not forget the system's radar detection and pellet firing launchers have also been improved. Can you see why everyone is eagerly waiting to see how the Barak will hold up in a fight? This tank will also feature advanced observation and night capabilities that will provide its crew a competitive edge in close-range combat when night falls just seems overkill. But, it's not magic though. All of these will be made possible by enhanced intelligence collection and sharing systems through cutting-edge sensor infrastructure, providing a detailed terrain analysis. With everything that has been said and done, Israel is proving exactly why artificial intelligence can be such a game-changer in warfare. But don't take our word for it. Here is an expert analysis of the Barak from Mark Dubowitz, the CEO of the Foundation of Defense Democracies. Israel has said it intends to be an AI superpower and is proving this in defense, the natural and necessary springboard for its technological innovations. The Barak's design suggests that the Israelis are keeping their eyes on southern Lebanon and Gaza, whose terrorists pose specific threats to mechanized ground forces. Just like the United States of America, Israel is fast becoming a key player in groundbreaking technology and artificial intelligence and the cutting-edge chips that make it tick. However, if the rumors are proven to be right, it is safe to say Israel will not be stopping here. There is still a lot of room to improve both air and maritime technologies, and you can bet all hands are on deck. If they succeed in those departments, their adversaries will be left catching their breath. Moving on, have you noticed Israel is taking a lot of inspiration from civilian technology? Think about the smooth operating system, the Iron Vision helmet, and even the joystick. The reason for this is quite simple. With many young recruits becoming familiar with smartphones and gaming, integrating virtual reality displays will feel like home, leveraging their understanding of such technology. The user interface isn't only smooth and friendly but also designed for teaching with a lot of importance on accessibility and quick understanding. Right now, the first wave of Barak tanks is being delivered to the Israeli Defense Forces for immediate testing and deployment into the 401st Armored Brigade, but with a lot of dreams on its back. IMAD Director General Eyal Zamir already referred to tanks as the backbone of the armored corps and on-ground fighting, not to mention Brigadier General Oren Jiber, the head of the Defense Merkava and Armored Vehicles Directorate, waxing lyrical on the Barak and openly declaring it sets a very high standard of technological excellence for the IDF, thanks to its unique weapon system, the advanced technology added to it, and built-in flexibility. Now, you're probably wondering how expensive the new AI-powered Barak tank is, aren't you? After all, the improved features and technological advancements like artificial intelligence and more would have cost a fortune. But what if we told you the Barak cost just as much as the Merkava 4? Yup, you heard right. According to the officials of the Defense Ministry, the Barak costs around $3.5 million, which is roughly the same as its predecessor. Right now, everything is working according to plan. The Barak tank will be the new face of the nation's tanks, just as they have been doing for a long time. The Merkava has always been the big tank for the IDF since the 80s, but lately, they've been refreshing the ranks by shelving the Mark III tanks for the fancier Mark IV ones, introduced in 2003. With mass production of the Barak already underway, you can expect the aging Merkava 4 to be gradually phased out while the newer Barak captains the IDF's armored units. To buttress this, officials are already planning to produce dozens of Baraks each year and, by the end of 2025, replace the Merkava 4. If there's one man we'd love to be right now, it has to be Colonel Benny Aharon, the commanding officer of the 401st Armored Brigade. While we wait to see what the Barak is capable of, he and his men are already playing with the Barak. But it's nice to see he is impressed, openly saying the addition of the Barak is an amazing opportunity to improve operational effectiveness. The 401st Armored Brigade sees the Barak tank as a historic event and a national mission for victory in the next campaign. We were privileged to be the first Armored Brigade to receive the Barak tank, and, therefore, a great responsibility rests on our shoulders. Our mission is to fulfill it with distinction, he explained. There are so many talking points about the Barak tank, but for now, just think about the extraordinary leaps it is making. It is a clear indication of just how far Israel is willing to go to improve and secure the technological edge of the IDF in both offense and defense. The Barak doesn't just meet expectations, it redefines them. It sets a new standard in military innovation and the perfect way to mark Israel's 50-year remembrance of the 1973 Yom Kippur War. That said, what are your favorite features about the Barak tank? Would it be significantly better than the aging Merkava 4 set to take a secondary role within Israel's military units?